In this session, we're going to look at entering time in the payroll module. In payroll, under task, you'll select enter time. The first thing it's going to ask you about here is what view you want to enter into, and the view determines what columns will show up in your entry grid when you're entering time. So I can pull up a list there, and these are the different views we have set up in the system. I'm going to select standard, click OK to that. You can put in a period begin date for your payroll. It's optional, so I'm going to leave that blank. And then a period end date. And I'll just put in today's date. Just type that in there. And so that's the period end date for our payroll for this entry session here. Enter that information and click OK. Then you get your entry grid here. I'm going to stretch the walls out here so I can see all the column information. Then you just go through and fill out each of the pieces of information here. So the first column I come across is the employee. If I know the ID, I can just type it in. If I don't, I can pull up a list. I can hit the F4 key on my keyboard to pull up a list. Or I can just click on the list button down at the bottom here. So I'm just going to select the first employee there, number 101. Then I have the job column. So the time entry can either go to a job or doesn't have to go to a job. So again, I can pull up the list for the jobs and select a job for it to go to. Now, if I'm job costing this time entry, I also have to select the cost code for the time to go against. So pull up a list on that, and this is my list of cost codes on this job here that have been used on this job so far. If I don't look at my standard cost code list, I can click the View button and select the standard cost codes, click OK to that, and then those are all the cost codes that are available to me from my standard list and job cost. So I'm going to select View and go back to the job cost codes, the job specific cost codes, click OK, and just choose that coordination cost code. Next field is my pay ID. So every time entry will have a pay ID. And a pay ID will represent whether it's regular time, overtime, double time, vacation, holiday, whatever type of pay it is here. Pull up a list of those pay IDs. And it pre-filled from the employee setup, so it came in with regular. On the employee setup, it was set that way to pre-fill for, so I'm just going to use the regular pay ID here. The units, so maybe it's just 8 hours for this day. The pay rate pre-fills from the employee setup also, or it could be coming from a pay rate table. So the system will retrieve the highest rate, whichever is on the employee record, and from whichever is in a pay rate table. So the rate coming in, and that can be overridden if you'd like to. I'll tab past that, and that first time entry is in there. Now, if I have a second time entry for this employee, I'll let this just continue on here. So it's going to bring the information from the previous line. So you see the employee ID pre-fills. That comes from the previous line there. I just tab through that. There's the job, cost code, and pay ID. So maybe this time it's an overtime pay, so I'll just pull up my list there, start typing in OT for the pay ID, and select that, and then maybe a couple hours of overtime that way. There's the overtime rate. From the setup of this pay ID, it tells it to take 1.5 times the regular rate. Now this message here is telling me that this pay ID is using a category that may not have been used on this job so far, and it wants me to verify that this is the correct category. So I'm going to click OK to that. And then here's the category coming in for OT, which has never been used on this job yet for this cost code. So I'm just confirming that's the correct one, accept that, and then add that from the standard list and job cost. Okay, so that's time entry for regular and overtime. Maybe having some more regular time to put in. Maybe this time I didn't go to a job. I can blank the job field there and just continue on past that, get to the pay ID. Now when I get to this information, I don't need to pull up a list every time to select it. I can just type it in if I know what it is. Type that in, put in some more hours there, and continue on. So that's for employee 101. If I have more time entries for another employee, I can just continue on in this particular batch session. I can go to employee 102 and start entering time for that employee. Just like that. So You can enter as many time entries as you need to in this entry session. Can be multiple employees, and then when you're done with that, with entering your time, then you can finish out of there. Some other buttons here, there's a totals button, which will give you a total of all your time entries there. Detail there, if I go to an existing line entry, so I'll click on an existing entry there, go to the detail button, that'll bring up more information, more field you can enter into for this entry. So these are all these fields are could be available in your time entry grids and your grid. So if you customize your time entry grid, these are all the fields you could have available in your grid. If you don't see it in your grid, you can access those fields through this detail button here. The attachments button there would allow you to enter either a transaction note or a file link if you want to link and attach a file here also. So you have file links and then notes right here to enter into the transaction itself. Okay, so I'm gonna close out of that. And then with that set, with those time entries in there, if I'm done with that, I'm just gonna finish out of that window. Okay, when I finish out of here, it's gonna bring up my print selection window to print the entry journal. I'm gonna print this to a print file. When I click start, it'll ask me for a file name. Let's name it PR Enter Time, save that. And then those time entries are in the new PRT file, in the new transaction file in payroll. Okay, so that printed, completed normally there. To go see my printout, I can go to the File menu, File and Printouts, and pull up that PR Enter Time file. Okay, so there's the journal of the time entries that I just entered. And then to the right there, I've got the totals, the hours and the dollar amount totals. And I just have one page on this journal here. Okay, so I'm gonna close out of that. So that's my entry journal. If I had several batches that I've entered in of time entries and I wanna see them all in the same report, the time entry report will show me that also. If I go to the reports menu, and then pay period processing and timesheet, here's where I can run a report of all the time entries in for that particular period end date. So I'm going to select the new transaction file for all the entries that have not been posted yet. Click OK to that. And then I'll put in a period end date range of 4/13. And print preview that. And that would be a report of all the time entries I've entered in for that period end date. You can also look at an inquiry. So one of the more common inquiries you may run in payroll will be under inquiry, check information, and check activity. Run that off the new transaction file. And then here's the beginning of both the checks that I've entered in for the two people for the time entries. To see those time entries, you can double click on the entry. And there's the time entries for employee 101. And go back to the previous screen, and then the time entries for employee 102. Okay, so just close that out. And that's how you can enter time into payroll.